What's up, Keegan? What's up, man?
Hey, Sean, how you doing, man?
Man, it's good, man. It's good to see you again. I got to start this off with, is there anything you can't do? You do it all, man. You all up in Jingle Jangle. Man, you were singing like a runaway cast member from The Wiz, man. You were, like, just doing it.
I got to write that down. Runaway cast member from The Wiz. That's fantastic, man. Man, that is a perfect description.
How much fun did you have with this, man? It just seemed like everybody. It's a throwback. I mean, it just felt good watching this movie.
Yeah, it feels like a Christmas Carol. Like, I remember when I was a kid, the part of the reason I wanted this movie, you remember in the 70s, in the mid 70s, there was a movie called Scrooge with Albert Finney. And all the hundreds of dancers. It was that same kind of energy and feeling. And that's part of why I wanted to do it. And the fact that I was like, I'm hip to this whole thing where we're in Victorian England and everybody's a person of color. Okay. Let's do it.
I was gonna ask you that. I mean, how refreshing was that? Because it's done in the movie, but no one makes reference to it. It's like
It's my favorite part. It's my favorite part. That's my absolute favorite part. It's in a way, because of what you just said, it's the opposite of The Wiz. What's most refreshing about it is like, no, we're not in the inner city. We ain't doing no. We went the exact opposite way. And that's the thing that I think could be the most revolutionary, is that we're not commenting on it. The wonderful thing is you notice it in the wardrobe. You notice it in the hair pieces. You notice it in the aprons they wear. There's always these little hints to our heritage. And it's done so discreetly and tastefully and gracefully. But that dichotomy of those two cultures being fused together on top of this wonderful story. So lots of kudos to Dave Talbert, who, you know, wrote and directed this.
No, I know. Dave gets a lot of credit for doing this because, like, is it me or should I feel weird? But, you know, as I was watching, I just wanted to hit the pause button because you can do that because it's on Netflix. And I just wanted to, like, I just wanted to cry for a second. Not a sad cry, but be like, oh, man, this is, like, that's the kind of feeling I got.
I know the feeling you're talking about, because it's like, kudos to David and also to Netflix for going, you go ahead and make this. We're going to give you the money to make this. And also, this is over 20 years in the making for David and Lynn. His wife, Lynn, is the producer. They've been working on this project for a long, long time. And for it to finally come to fruition, it took something like Netflix that decided Netflix does not have those kind of parameters. They were like, this is an interesting vision, and we want you to bring it to fruition. Yeah.
Well, we have to definitely circle the word dedication, because 20 years is a long time to keep any dream alive. So I'm glad they had the fortitude to do that. Now, this movie had me all up in my holiday feels. I want to find out from you, what's the most exciting toy you ever received for Christmas?
The most exciting toy I ever got, and it was a couple years in coming too, by the way. I got one of those Star Wars AT-ATs. Remember the AT-ATs with the four legs? They used to on Hoth. They were on the snow, and they had the little things, the little tusk things that were laser guns.
Yes.
That was my jam right there. I was like, I have to have this. Please, Dad, maybe next year. And finally we got one, and it was like the best. Like, you know, you were a kid, you play with a toy, and then you're like, uh-huh. And then you go to the next toy. I loved that toy. I played with it for a lot, you know. So maybe I played with it for like,
Dude, we have a lot in common, because the Star Wars toys for me, and I don't know if we had the same set of parents or what, but mine was also a couple years in the making, but I finally got the remote control R2-D2.
There it is. That's up there.
This is the most organically inclusive interview I've ever had, where we're just talking about this movie, which is dope, and two black men sharing stories about Star Wars toys. You do what you're doing, man. I love it, man. I always love your energy, man.
Hey, thank you, Sean.
Healthy, man. Thanks a lot, Keegan.
You too. Take care, man. Thank you. Happy holidays.
You too.